लास्ट कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी डिस्कस करेंगे, दैट इज एलिवेशन इन बॉइलिंग पॉइंट। इसका मतलब ये हुआ कि जब हम नॉन वोलेटाइल सॉल्यूट को ऐड करते हैं सॉल्वेंट के अंदर, तो सॉल्यूशन का बॉइलिंग पॉइंट लिक्विड सॉल्वेंट से ज्यादा होता है। रीजन ये है कि सम ऑफ द सॉल्यूट मॉलिक्यूल विल ऑक्युपाई द स्पेसेस ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल, देयरफॉर द एस्केपिंग टेंडेंसी ऑफ द सॉल्यूट सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल शुड बी लेस, सॉरी सॉल्यूशन शुड बी लेस इन कंपैरिजन विद द सॉल्वेंट, देयरफॉर द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन शुड बी मोर देन द प्योर सॉल्वेंट। हम लेट अस टेक द एग्जांपल, वी कैन, दिस इज द टेंपरेचर एंड दिस इज वेपर प्रेशर। Now, I told you the vapor pressure of the solution is always more than that of the pure solvent. This is represented by delta T, delta TV, and this is vapor pressure for solution and this is vapor pressure for pure solvent. Now, in case of solution, the vapor pressure should be increased due to the less escaping tendency in comparison with the pure solvent. Now, this change in vapor pressure is represented by delta TB, and delta TB is directly proportional to molar concentration of the solvent in solution. Now, or we can write delta TB equal to TB M. It means where T, so T B, it is not TB, it is KB, where KB is called ebullioscopic constant or molar elevation constant. Now, when the molar concentration equal to 1, delta TB equal to AB, and hence we can define the ebullioscopic constant is defined as the elevation in boiling point when the molar concentration of solution should be 1. It means it is the elevation in boiling point when M equal to 1, molar solution concentration of the solution should be 1. And this, now this equation delta TB equal to KBM is used for the determination of molar mass of solute. How? As we know that M, that is molality, equal to WB upon, that is weight of solvent, solvent solute divided by the molar mass multiplied by 1000 divided by weight of solvent. And when we put, this is equation number 1, this is 2, when we put in two, equation number 2 in 1, we get delta TB equal to WB upon MB into 1000 upon WA into KB. From here, we can calculate MB equal to WB into 1000 multiplied by AB divided by delta TB into of molar Kb, that is ebullo-stoping constant, should be known if we can calculate the mass of solute. Now, the question is, since the molarity depends upon number of moles of solute, hence we can call elevation in boiling point is a colligative property. Since the colligative properties depend on the concentration of the volatile solute, and there another thing, the solute molecule should not undergo association or dissociation in with the solvent. Number three, the number of solute particle associate or number of solute particle dissociate. These are the three factors which changes the molecular mass that we can calculate for the solute, from osmotic pressure, relative loading of vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point. Now the question is, when there is change in the normal molecular mass from the observed normolecular mass, that is called abnormal molecular mass. And we can calculate that abnormal molecular mass by a Von Hoff factor, and we can call Von Hoff factor is represented by I, and I is the ratio of normal molecular molar mass and the abnormal molar mass. It means I equal to normal molar mass divided by abnormal or observed molecular mass. There are three cases for this Von Hoff factor when I is greater than 1. It means there is dissociation. When I is less than 1, there is association, and when I is equal to 1, neither dissociation nor association of the solvent molecule. Now, here why I is greater than 1? The reason is that during dissociation, the number of molecule should be less in solute. Similarly, when I is greater than 1, it means there is association of the molecule. For example, benzoic acid. What it can do? It forms intermolecular this form. This is the concept of association, and this is the concept of dissociation. For example, acetic acid, it can dissociate, gives. It means mass should be decreases, here mass should be increases.